Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial. This is the third section of the How to Create a Necklace in uMake tutorial series. We're actually kind of making more of a choker, but as you can see, we created this nice shape or this nice piece here. And what we're going to do in this lesson is we're going to walk you through the steps to make an array of this and turn it into something that looks more like a necklace or a choker. So to get started, I'm going to select this whole piece here. And you can see that I have this circle that I created, and I'm going to use that circle to create an array around. So now that I have the whole piece that I've made selected, I'm going to go to the top view. I'm going to tap array, and I'm going to move this over like that. And you'll see because we have the circle, it snaps into place. Now I'm going to move the number of copies up, and we might get lucky where they'll overlap a little bit. And there we go. At 15, they overlap just perfectly. And you can see that as they overlap, you get this really cool looking necklace or choker. Now it's a little bit geometric, but I've seen chokers out there like that made out of little pieces of metal and that are hinged together. So once I'm done, I'm gonna tap the green check mark and we have something that looks, I think, relatively nice. Now I'm going to get rid of this circle down here. I don't need that anymore. And now you have a couple options of things that you can do. Once you know that it's about 15 that you need, you can come in and you can do a couple different things to it. So if I tap the undo button and go back to the state prior to the array, what I can do is I can add some depth to this if I want. And basically, to do that, you would just go through and kind of get in an angle like this. And you could go through each surface and use the push-pull functionality and just kind of pull back a little bit on each surface. Now, this could be relatively time-consuming. So if you want to do it, definitely go ahead. It'll make things look a little bit more interesting because they'll have some depth. But it's totally up to you if you want to do that. Now, again, I did this kind of assuming that the surface or this element would be relatively thin, so I didn't really go ahead and add the depth to the surfaces anyways, but you can if you want. Just go in and add some. So there you go, you can see that we've added some depth to this design. It looks a little bit nicer, and you can go ahead and add some other options to it as well. One other thing that you could also do is you could embellish the ends of this. For example, you could add some little spheres to it or some gemstones if you wanted to. I mean, that could look pretty nice. And I think I'm actually gonna do that on the bottom or the top. I might actually come over here to the playground, come into product and then jewelry. And let's see, I might add a little circle cut here. Shrink this way down. I'll just put it on one end for now since they're going to be overlapping. And so that could be pretty nice. So you have a couple different options, but basically what you can do is now come in and select that now that you have the depth and everything and a nice little gemstone. And we'll do the same thing again. Go to the top view, tap array, bring the point in like that, go to copies and bring in, go to 15. And how does that look? Looks pretty cool. So there is your necklace or your choker. I hope you enjoyed this. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, definitely let us know. You can find us on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. We would love to see what kind of necklaces or jewelry you create. If you have any suggestions for us in terms of tutorials to make or functionality that would really help you design your jewelry, definitely let us know. We would love to hear from you. And that concludes this tutorial series as well. Thanks guys for watching, and we would love to see what you make. Take care. Have a great day. Bye-bye.